Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. This is third video on Pelton Turbine in which we are going to discuss or we are going to derive the expression for the work done by jet in the direction of motion on blade. Okay, so these are the steps I have written which we need to follow to for the derivation of work done, and this is the velocity triangle for Pelton Turbine which I have already discussed in my previous video, which I will link I will give in the description box below. If you haven't seen, please go through that. Okay, so first step is force exerted by jet in the direction of motion. So we know that force is rate of change of momentum. That is Newton's second law. Okay, second law of motion. Rate of change of momentum, as we are finding jet, force exerted by jet on blade. So we will take initial momentum minus final momentum. Okay, now as we need to find rate of change of momentum, so we'll take mass flow rate and initial momentum, that is initial velocity in the direction of jet, that is VW1. Okay, so this is VW1 minus final velocity will be what? VW2, and that is in the opposite direction, so we'll take what? Minus VW2. So this is what? Minus VW2. Okay, so this is mass flow rate VW1 plus VW2, minus minus will become plus. And mass flow rate, mass is what? Density into volume. So density into volume, and we need to find rate means divided by time. Okay, so volume can be written as area into length divided by time, and length, distance upon time, is what? Speed. So this is rho a v1, because speed is what? V1, that is velocity of jet. Okay, so mass flow rate can be written as rho a v1 in bracket VW1 plus VW2. This is force. So this is the equation for force that is exerted by jet in the direction of motion on the blade. Okay, now we need to find the work done by jet on runner, that is per second. So work done per second. Work done is what? Force into displacement. Now as we are talking about per second, so we have to divide it by time. Force into displacement upon time is what? Velocity. Okay, so we need to find the work done per second by jet on runner. Okay, so we'll see the velocity of runner. So this is what? Force into velocity of runner is what? U. The runner is moving with velocity U. Okay, now force is what? Force is mass flow rate, that is rho a v1 vw1 plus vw2 into U. I have just put this value here in place of F. Okay, so we got the formula rho a v1 vw1 plus vw2 into U. This is what? Work done per second. Now if you need to find work done per unit weight, then it can be written as rho a v1 vw1 plus vw2 into U per unit weight. So weight is what? Mass is what? Rho a v1. And if you need to find weight, weight is what? Mg. So mass is this, and we need to multiply by g. G is acceleration due to gravity. So rho a v1 will cancel out. Here we get vw1 plus vw2 into U divided by g. This is what? Work done per unit weight. And also if you need to find the power to runner by jet, if you need to find the power transferred to runner by jet, so this will be what? Work done per second is what? This unit of this is joule, and joule is what? Joule is watt per second. Okay, sorry, watt is what? Joule per second. So we here we find work done per second, so this is joule per second, and joule per second is what? Watt. So this can be written as power, that is rho a v1 vw1 plus vw2 into U. This will be what? Watt. And when we divide it by 1000, we get it in kilowatt. So this is the power. Okay, I hope you understand till here. Let us just take a brief view of this. Steps for finding the work done is force exerted by jet in the direction of motion. Next, force done, work done per second by jet on runner, then work done per unit weight, then power to runner. Okay, now this is the velocity triangle. This is only we require just to find the direction of VW2. Okay, that is minus VW2, opposite to the direction of flow of blade. Okay, movement of blade. So force is what? Rate of change of momentum by Newton's second law. So rate of change of momentum, we are need to find the change of momentum, that is force exerted by jet on blade. Okay, then we'll take initial to final. When we calculate from blade by blade to jet, then we'll take final minus initial. So this is initial minus final. So mass flow rate, momentum is mass into velocity. So mass flow rate and the direction is VW1 velocity. So VW1 minus VW2 because it is in opposite direction. So when you solve this, you get this. Mass flow rate is what? Rho A V1. This is how we derive it. Now force we got here. Okay. Work done per second is what? Force. Force into displacement is work done. When we find per second, so we have to divide it by time. Displacement by time is what? Velocity. Okay. This is what? Velocity of runner, because we need to find on runner. So we have to see the velocity of runner. So this is U. And value of U is what? U is pi D N by 60, where D is what? Diameter of runner, or you can say wheel. Okay. We put the value of F here into U. This is what? Joule per second, work done per second. And joule per second is what? It can be expressed as watt. Okay. We need to find kilowatt, then we'll divide it by 1000. This is what? Power transferred to runner. We convert watt to kilowatt by dividing by 1000. Work done per unit weight is also calculated. That is work done per second divided by per unit weight. Okay. So rho A1 will cancel. By G is multiplied, because rho AV1 is mass into G, that is the acceleration due to gravity, we get what? Weight. So this is VW1 plus VW2 U by G. This is work done per unit weight. So I hope you got all these formulas. In my next video, we will see the derivation for hydraulic efficiency. What is the maximum efficiency? That we will see in next video. Till then, bye.